for class. Hey, Barry, pull up the classroom feed.
All right, students.
Let's settle
in. No, hide it there.
Anybody want to play Zerbitin Research?
I bet you I'm going to win this one.
I wonder what's for lunch today.
I really hope they have kelp burgers.
It's time for your final planet project.
And my favorite. Today, you're going to apply everything you've learned this year.
I'd like you to find a planet in this galaxy and explain how its atmosphere works. Go all out and have fun.
Seriously, I want y'all to have a good time. Let's do it.
I remember my final planet project. Lost an engine getting too close to one of the planet's rings. Met the weirdest creatures on this ice-covered moon.
Oh, and that volcanic planet, the whole place almost exploded on me.
Good times.
I want all of you to really dig into these planets. There's a lot out there to explore.
Best of luck. Extra credit.
For anyone who finds those ice creatures.
And tells them, teachers Pika and Puna.
Say hi. Yeah!
Looking for planets, looking for planets.
Nope, not that one. Not that one either.
Whoa, check that planet out. It's like 70% water.
Understand this world? Hi, I'm Teek. Okay, Barry, look up NOAA. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. They seem like intelligent life.
They call it NOAA for short.
Oh, Tom Di Liberto, climate scientist at NOAA. I bet Tom knows a lot about how the ocean and atmosphere work on this planet. Let's go visit. Barry, take me to NOAA to see Tom.
Okay, going to Tom at NOAA.
Bye, everyone.
Hey, Eric, Sharon, have a nice weekend.
Okay, you too.
I can't wait to set up that new weather station this weekend. Oh, I'm gonna have so much new data. Temperature data, pressure data, precipitation data. I can calculate my own heat index. Is 5 thermometers too many thermometers? Meh. What's better than 1 temperature reading?
5 temperature readings.
Cumulus. Gonna collect some data. Gonna collect some data. Gonna collect. What was that? Wait. What? How? Who?
Hi, NOAA climatologist Tom Di Liberto. I'm Teek from planet Queloz. I come in peace. Can you help me understand your planet for a school project?
Whoa, you're real. And you know my name. Always happy to help students. Welcome to Earth.
But just to be clear, this isn't part of a giant plot to take over our planet because I really like Earth. It's kind of awesome.
You're funny. We stopped conquest thousands of years ago. Kind of primitive, if you ask me.
Of course. Well, nice to meet you. I'm Tom, but you know that already. What do you want to know?
Okay, I have so many questions. How old is your planet? You have a lot of water. Why don't you live in it? Does water fall from those white fluffy things in the sky? Do any of your ice creatures know my teachers, Pika and Puna?
Slow down, that's a lot. It sounds like you want to know how our ocean, water cycle, and atmosphere interact on Earth to affect our weather and climate. Well, you've come to the right person.
Yes! Sounds like we might need a trip to space to check out those fluffy things. Woo! Why don't you hop aboard BARY, my bioluminescent alien research yacht?
I can do that?
BARY, take us to space!
Caution, Tom. Non-Queloz life forms may not maintain molecular cohesion.
Huh?
Beginning assimilation. In 3, 2, 1.
Oh my gosh, I'm in space! Look at Earth, it's so beautiful! Why am I yelling?
Wait, is this your first time in space? Wow, you Earthlings need to get out more. But your planet is really pretty, and I've seen a few.
Yeah, it is. Calm down, Tom. Breathe. Okay, so let's go over the difference between weather and climate on Earth. Those white fluffy things, clouds, are water droplets. And yes, some of them even release water on the Earthlings. We call it rain.
Huh. I only experience rain when I order it. Do you get caught in the rain?
No. That's a hypothetical.
Tom, that's inaccurate. My intergalactic intelligence system shows you getting soaked yesterday.
Wait, how did you get that video? Okay, yeah. Yesterday I got caught in the rain. That's why it's important to check the weather forecast before you go out, otherwise you might end up wet. But did you also know there are climate outlooks that look at weather trends weeks and months into the future?
Like, for whether it'll be a good season for growing zworples?
Well, yes. Growing food for Earthlings. But we don't have zworples.
Oh. So what is the difference between weather forecasts and climate outlooks?
Weather forecasts give us exact numbers. BARY, what's today's weather forecast at NOAA?
In Washington, D.C., today's high will be 80 degrees Fahrenheit with a low of 64.
Thanks. So that's today's weather. But if you're ever thinking the weather is hotter, colder, wetter, or drier than normal, now you're thinking climate. Climate's just the average of many, many years of weather data.
But that still seems weathery to me. What about climate outlooks? And who on Earth uses them?
Well, for that, I think we need to head to a farm. Because farmers plan months in advance. Oh, see that area right there? That's where a lot of farms are.
I'll take us there quick. Hold on! BARY, take us to a farm!
I'll miss you, space.
Yeah, a farm! Earthling food production! What's that machine? Can I ride it? How fast does it go?
That's a tractor. Have fun. Promise you'll pay attention.
Promise!
Teek, the crops you're driving by are sweet corn. Many, many months ago, the farmer used a NOAA climate outlook to decide what to plant this year, corn or soybeans. When the farmer looked at the climate outlook, which we Earthlings create using past years of weather data and predictions of the future, they noticed it was likely to be wetter than average.
and that meant corn would be the better crop. Which, by the looks of it, the farmer was right.
Rich wheat corn is tasty.
I know, right? So while climate outlooks can't prevent drought or lots of rain, the climate outlooks help farmers decide what to plant and when to harvest.
Oh, that's really cool. Here on Earth, knowing what the weather and climate will be can be really important.
Yep. But did you know that the ocean also affects the weather and climate?
I believe you, Tom from NOAA. So, is the ocean making those dark, fast-moving clouds?
Wait, what? Oh gosh, we gotta get out of here.
Perfect, yeah! Okay, Barry, let's get out of here and go to the, ocean.
Making that weird face. Oh! Sorry about that. I didn't realize he couldn't breathe underwater.
We can breathe everywhere. Maybe one day you will. Your kind is so delicate.
Yes, delicate. Teek, you might be surprised how often Earth's atmospheric scientists are looking out on the ocean and not up for a clue on what's to come. All of that water that falls out of the sky, like from those storms at the farm, has to come from somewhere.
This is so great! I love that the ocean and atmosphere work together! I have so many more questions!
Our ocean is a wild place! And there's so much more to talk about. There's hurricanes and computer models and robot ships and satellites and climate change and...
Oh, no! That's my parental figure. I really need to get home. Maybe next time?
Deal.
Barry, let's drop Tom off back at NOAA. Here, we can communicate with this.
Great! I can't wait to help you find all the answers. Oh, looks like it's about to rain. Oh, I don't have my umbrella.
Earthlings. Barry, print Tom an umbrella.
Whoa, thanks.
My friends aren't gonna believe that I'm in a creature that can only breathe above water.
I was just in space. What is this? Gross. Ugh.
That went way better than I could have hoped. Barry, please open my student log.
Student log opened, ready to record.
Day one, final project. Landed on a beautiful planet that inhabitants call Earth, and it's over 70% water. And get this. The intelligent life there don't order their weather. Instead, scientist Earthling Tom told me that they make weather forecasts and climate outlooks to help other Earthlings prepare and be safe.
Accurate. And don't forget, weather forecasts are forecasts for exact weather conditions, while climate outlooks are more about how things will be different than normal.
Tom also explained how farmers use climate outlooks to help determine what and when to plant. Then I almost drowned, Tom. I didn't know we couldn't breathe underwater. After that, Tom was just about to explain how important the ocean is to how weather and climate work on Earth, but then the parental figure called, and I had to leave. Fast.
Yes, parental figure is expecting you back at agreed upon curfew.
I know. End student log day one.
Barry, I'm gonna rest for a bit.
Wake me up when we're close to Queloz. Oh, and remind me to bring Tom some Zwarples next time.
Affirmative. Log complete.